So, Al, where are you gonna go to?
Somewhere where shoe men run wild and free in the big sky. Where never is heard an impregnated word, and the hooters are uncovered all day.
That's beautiful, Al.
That's beautiful.
Monocles, family trees, gum. Gentlemen, would you like to be somebody?
Your shirt.
How much for an ex-football player with a cool name?
$200.
What can I get for a buck?
A shoe salesman named Al.
Give me some gum. Hey, I'll pick my own name, huh? My new name will be, Bazooka Joe. Excuse me.
That's the doorbell, Al. Come in!
Oh, hi. I'm Brenda. I'm your new neighbor. I just moved into the house across the street.
Oh, yeah. The old Thompson house. You know, he used to be in charge of the soy trough over at Mr. Eggroll. But then he got promoted to the guy who says, what size drink with that? So we knew we'd be moving to a better neighborhood. Hi, I'm Peggy.
Hi.
If you want anyone to tell a secret to, just tell me. Oh, and if you need any gossip on any of the neighbors, just ask me. People tell me everything.
Yeah? Well, I've already heard about the people who live on the other side of you. The Bundys. Boy, the stories I've been hearing about them. They say the husband will steal your paper, stalk your pets, and eat your garbage.
Hey, half a potato is not garbage.
Anyway, this moving in is difficult. It's harder because I don't have a man.
I know. Where do you find one these days?
Anyway, listen, the movers, they left my couch out in front of the house, and I have a job interview. I dance on tables for men near airports. So I was wondering if you could watch it for me until I get back.
Well, a quarter might keep my eyes open.
You know, it's funny, a quarter used to keep them closed in high school. Well, miss, it's my day off, and as you can see, I'm all alone. So, I don't mind moving that couch for you.
Well, it is a big couch. But then you're a big man. Hi, I'm Brenda Kozdrowski. Peggy, do you mind if I borrow this big, strong guy?
Yeah, okay. Just have him back by tomorrow. He has to perform brain surgery in the morning, and he has a loafer sale in the afternoon.
Well, my mother worries so. After you, my rear. My dear.
You are too tired to fix the doorbell, and yet you can go move her couch?
Yeah. Let's hurry up and get that couch inside before Peg wants to go sit on it.
Ladies, allow me to introduce myself. I'm Lauren Michaels, producer of Mr. Empty Pants, the movie. Now, we're casting a very important part, buttocks.
Yeah!
You all qualify. Now, rehearsals start in the broom closet in 5 minutes.
Hey, wait a second. Just a minute ago, you were the body makeup guy.
Hey, babe. I'm going places. Hopefully, this place, and that place.
Make way for Mr. Empty Pants. Okay, EP, these are the girls who'll be doing the centerfold with you.
I'd like you to know that after the shoot, I'm going to shake every one of your hooters.
The bigger the star, the nicer the guy.
Well, Empty, look, before we put you on the bearskin rug with the ladies, we'd like a few shots, you know, so we can capture the inner emptiness. Yeah. Meantime, I think we need some powder on the girls. Makeup!
Uh-oh. Those breasts are shiny. Take off those tops. Oh, and don't worry about me getting excited. I'm gay.
All right, I think the boys had enough fun.
Well, let's go, let's go. Oh, I gotta get loose. Play my music. Helps me shake my moneymaker.
Shoot, we have to find another centerfold. Mr. Empty Pants has been killed in the latest strip.
Oh. Okay, girls, let's take a break. No, don't take my breasts away.
Girls, let's go. Wait, excuse me, ladies, Bud Bundy here, Department of Makeup Safety. If left on, that stuff can kill. Yes, it must be licked off immediately. Believe me, I'll receive no pleasure from this other than a job well done. Now quickly, D-top and meet me on the old mattresses in the alley. And hurry, hurry! Your chests are ticking time bombs!
For years, we have been tortured by the shrill voices of our nagging wives. But at last, we have found a man who speaks to us all, a man who married for our sins. Let's everybody give it up for the Reverend Al Bundy.
Vixens, Hannah, and Luya. Believers, guests, those of you with the deep pockets that got the cushioned seats up front, let me tell you a little story. God created man. Everything was going great. Then Eve came around and said, Apple. The one time they offer us something to eat, bam, we wind up selling women's shoes. Now! I know that a lot of you are wondering what the Church of No Ma'am is all about. Hooters! Yes, but we're also about making the world something it used to be. Mm-hmm. Back when
and men were men, and women were ribs.
Tell it, Reverend Al!
When a driver's side airbag was called a mother-in-law. When a frank conversation with the wife used to begin with "What's for dinner?" and ended with "You call that dinner?"
Would you like a squeeze?
Oh, yes.
Blot your brow.
Bless you, my child. Though I see you've already been blessed.
But it is our mission to bring back the natural order of things. Mm-hmm. Guy things. Mm-hmm. Amen! Like barber shops, hardware stores. Those calendars, you lift the cellophane, she's naked in there. To bring us back to those times. This is an engine that runs on money. I'm not talking about that unleaded, eco-friendly, tree-hugging, girly-jiggling money.
You go, preacher man!
I'm talking about beer-guzzling, truck-driving, low-riding, belching, fighting, folding money! Now, if no one wants to testify, we'll pass the collection plate.
I want to testify.
A woman! Now, 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 let us not jump to conclusions.
You want me to take her down, Reverend Al?
That will not be necessary, Brother Archimedes. The days are over when a woman could whoop us like a nation of Jerry Coonies. Yeah!
Actually, I have very little to say.
A 1994 Dodge Viper.
Now let me get this straight. When my Dodge goes over 1 million miles, you give me that car?
Well, first, we want to film your car crossing the 1 million mile mark. But after that, Mr. Bundy, the Viper is yours.
Oh, Peg, I'm so happy I could shake your hand.
Al, it only has 2 seats. What about the kids?
It's got a trunk. Oh, Bill, speaking of family, who's going to play my young blonde wife in the commercial?
Hey, what about me?
Well, you don't play my wife in real life.
Besides, you
hated the Dodge.
I did not.
Weren't you the one that got me the license plate holder that said I'd rather be driving?
That just shows you how close I am to the Dodge. We kid like that all the time.
Oh, no, Peg. You laughed at the Dodge. You mocked the Dodge. She shot the Dodge, but she didn't shoot the deputy.
What does that mean?
I don't know, Peg. I'm just babbling like this because I'm staring at her cleavage.